Donald Trump praising L.L. Bean's co-owner for standing up to liberals calling for a boycott because she supports Donald Trump. Trump tweeting, "Thank you to Linda Bean of L.L. Bean for your great support and courage. People are going to support you even more now. Buy L.L. Bean." Kind of an ad. And here's Linda Bean saying why she is not backing down. Take a listen.
Well, it's a bullying. It's a bullying me personally. Yep. It's bullying now the company that didn't give the donation. I gave the donation personally to a PAC to support Trump. But the point is, we should have that privilege. We live in America. This is a free country.
Isn't it?
Mike, I love her attitude. Isn't that exactly how companies should deal with a lot of these liberal intimidation tactics?
You're exactly right, David. You have to act promptly. Otherwise, they're going to paint you as something you're not. And good for President-elect Donald Trump for tweeting out. The guy's got almost 20 million followers. People want to know what he has to say. Good for both of them.
Rich, what about her attitude? I think that's the way you stand up to these things, right?
I think I applaud her for doing that, but at the same time, I think this grab my wallet campaign is going to burn itself out. There are 80 companies on their blacklist. Now, I always thought that liberals hated blacklists, but they've got 80 companies, and the sheer noise of it all and the weight of it all, it's going to burn itself out.
John, do you think she's doing the right thing in standing up to these people, these boycotters?
I love that she's standing up, but I also think that Rich is right. This is absurd. Look, we all produce in order to get what we don't have. The idea that suddenly people are going to compromise their living standards to fulfill some idiotic blacklist, it's going to die of its own absurdity.
Emac, what about Donald Trump coming out and essentially giving her an ad or giving L.L. Bean an ad by saying buy their stuff? And actually, we should mention that she claims the revenue has increased since the boycott began because of her standing up to it and Donald Trump's support.
And Donald Trump tweeting out, buy L.L. Bean.
Right.
I think he could be criticized, and critics will likely go after him for saying, why are you saying buy L.L. Bean? That doesn't look good for the president-elect to be, or any president to be saying that. You know, you could, a retailer who's a rival to L.L. Bean could say, listen, I make clothes in the USA. Why are you favoring L.L. Bean over my company? So I don't think you should put the presidency in that position.
Sabrina, on the other hand, and we better all get used to it. The tweeting hasn't slowed down at all from Donald Trump, and specifically on certain companies, whether he likes them or doesn't like them.
Right. I'm not wild about that personally, David. I think it's great that she came out and said what she wanted to say. People ought to be able, this is free expression, you ought to be able to give money to any candidate or PAC that you want to give to. I'm also with Rich on this. I think this is absurd, this idea that we're going to blacklist certain companies, whether you're on the liberal side of the aisle or the conservative one. You know, I don't really care, you know, who people support, if they're a good surgeon or a good electrician or they're a good actress. I just want them to do their job, and then we don't have to agree on everything.
But, Bill, some of these boycotts really hurt. I'm thinking of North Carolina. There were some issues there that people had with them. They called for a boycott of North Carolina. They lost a lot of business. Sometimes these things can hurt.
Yeah, I can't follow them all, though. I mean, am I supposed to boycott right. Macy's because I like Donald Trump, or am I supposed to boycott Macy's because I don't like Donald Trump?
That's because you're not a screaming liberal, Bill. If you were a liberal, you'd keep track of all these things.
I can't buy a breakfast cereal without checking out the politics. No, this is ridiculous, David. I'm not going to do that.
Mike, the fact is there are people that really do affect businesses. Again, when there was a call for boycotting North Carolina, certain convention centers stopped using hotels there, et cetera.
Yeah, and a lot of people go through the news, David, just looking at the headlines, right? And if you don't defend yourself and correct what people are perceiving you to be, then all of a sudden, if you repeat a lie long enough, people are going to think it's the truth. So she had to do what she did.
I don't mind, by the way, protests against government policies. If people want, that's free speech, what's right. going on with North Carolina's policies. But we're talking about companies and what this L.L. Bean, you know, granddaughter is saying. Yeah. They're out to cost people their jobs. It's the same issue with the Mozilla CEO, who I think lost his
right.
job.
Yeah.
It's about bullying the private sector. When it comes to government officials setting policy, it's okay to protest. I just think I like what she's saying and fighting
right.
back.
Rich, what about the fact that Donald Trump does focus on particular companies, for good or bad?
Well, I think that'll burn itself out, too. You know, I mean, he's the president-elect still, and his tweets make news. So, hey, but, you know, in the 50s, Republicans bought Fords and Democrats bought Chevys. So, in a sense, this is not that new.
Of course, he's read about that. He's not old enough to have lived through it. I just wanted to get that clear.
Well, we own two Fords. That
okay, there you go.
You need to know.